We are back with yet another episode of our preseason high school softball media day, and we are joined tonight by the Potomac School head coach Wayne Loving. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Nice to see you, Wayne.
Yep.
Again, thanks a lot for coming. Who did you bring with us tonight?
I brought my three captains.
Ooh.
Haley Richardson, Faye Butler, and Abby Rebhan.
All right.
Awesome. Welcome, ladies.
Glad
thanks
here,
again
ladies.
For coming.
Why don't you guys tell us a little bit about yourselves?
Okay. I'm Abby. As Coach Loving said, I'm a senior, and I play first, and I pitch.
I'm Faye, and I play left field and sometimes second base.
I'm Haley, and I mainly play center field and right field.
Awesome. Coach, you've been at the program a while now, yes?
I've been in Potomac for 25 years.
Exactly.
Yeah. That's a while.
That
qualifies
a while.
As a while.
I've been the head coach since 2013.
Excellent.
Wow. Good for you, man. Yeah. Good for you.
Tell us a little bit about, the private school, the way that it's aligned, right? You know, and your competition. So talk about the other teams, where, you know, your schedule and who you play and, you know, all of that kind of stuff with the alignment of the private school leagues.
Okay. Well, we're in the ISL,
yep.
Which is composed of two divisions. We're in the upper division, AA. There are eight teams in that division. The top teams are generally Flint Hill, National Cathedral, and that's pretty much it in ourselves.
Throw yourself in there, of
yeah,
course.
Yeah. And then we're also associated with the Virginia Independent School Association, which is made up of about 20, 25 schools throughout the state of Virginia. There are three divisions. We're in Division One, which is the division with the largest school population.
Right.
And for the last 3 or 4 years, we've either been ranked first or second wow. in the state. The last 3 years, we played in the state championship every year.
Yeah.
And we anticipate doing that again this year.
Awesome. Congratulations.
Yep. Yeah,
okay. So sometimes, ladies, you have to travel, right? Like it's not like school next door kind of type thing, right? So talk about how you prepare for, you know, maybe a longer bus ride or, you know, different times, game times and things like that, because it's not sort of your standard schedule, right?
I think one thing that's definitely different comparatively to public schools would be that our games are at 4:15 or 4:30 typically. So sometimes we have to like leave school early, especially with traffic. Like leaving school early is kind of normal for away games. And then as soon as you're like done playing and you go home, you kind of have to like do your homework and get it all done. But I'd say most of the schools are typically maybe like 30-ish to 45 minutes away. So it might be a little bit longer, but.
Great. What are your expectations? Coach sort of talked a little bit about what he thinks you guys are going to accomplish. What do you guys think you're going to accomplish this year?
I agree with him.
Smart.
To be completely honest, I think we're going to win the ISL again and then play in the state tournament.
And this year win.
Yes, this year win.
So last year you were in the state tournament and you lost, it sounds like, yeah? Who did you lose to?
Bishop O'Connell. 3 years in a row.
Second time. You know what? Bishop might be a close second to Riverside in terms of the hatred. I don't know. But
but if we've heard correctly, things might be a little different in the circle at O'Connell this
yeah.
year, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Look at that. Yeah.
Again, I can go get Susie from the back. She's right
she
back
is
there.
Here.
If you guys want to
yeah.
have
yeah.
a chat with her.
She'd like to duke it out, right?
Yeah. So, Coach, I would like to talk about your longevity in the game. 25 years is a long time. You've had a great career, but the game has really exploded in the last, 10 or 12 years, gone to new heights. We're seeing it on TV. Around here where we live, there's a lot more young girls playing the game. The numbers are up. What was your perspective on that? Have you been seeing that change, in the private school game too?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, I would say even 13, 14 years ago when I took over the varsity, if we had one travel player, we were lucky.
Yeah.
Now we have a roster of 11. 10 of those girls are either still playing travel or played travel in the past. And that just makes a world of difference.
Oh,
so.
Yeah.
So speaking of travel, ladies, what travel organizations do you play for if you're still playing travel?
I play for Rock.
Okay, Rock, nice.
I don't play play travel anymore, okay. But I used to play for Glory.
Glory? Mm-hmm. All right.
I nice. Used to play for Lady Lightning.
Okay. So two used to's and one current. Okay. Any aspirations for the college ball, or are we hanging up the cleats after we graduate?
I'm committed to play at Amherst College.
Oh, awesome. Congratulations. Good for you.
Thank
That's
you.
Awesome.
Faye, the Castellano Haley? Girls from Potomac, too?
Yeah.
Yes.
Anna, and then her yeah. sister just yeah. graduated, right? Yeah. 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 Erica. Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. And Alexis, right? Alexis Fawn.
Yep. Yeah, she's a junior.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, we've familiar yeah. names.
A lot of folks that we're familiar with. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of good travel players, too. You're yeah. right, Coach. Yeah. Yeah. That's awesome.
What do you guys do for fun outside of softball?
I play the guitar.
Oh, cool.
Yes, that's probably what I do mainly.
And you've been doing it for how long?
Just since the summer, but I do it all the time besides softball.
You're obsessed?
Yes, I'm pretty much obsessed.
Oh, that's great.
Do you sing and play or just play?
I try to sing.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I sing and play.
You play better than you sing, I guess.
Yes, for sure.
Faye, what about you?
I'd say I just, like, hang out with my friends and my family. I also like to bake.
Oh, sometimes nice.
When that's I have good. The time.
What do you bake?
Some brownies?
I actually did bake brownies yesterday.
Oh, man. Yeah. I love brownies.
And you didn't no,
you
nothing.
Didn't bring you didn't them bring in a trash bag?
I'm sorry.
You noticed the last team came with a bag of cookies, a trash bag full of cookies.
Next year.
Abby, how about you?
I also play volleyball, and then I really like journaling.
Awesome.
Nice. Very yeah. good.
How do you guys balance the academic side with the softball side or the volleyball side or the guitar playing side or the baking side? Like, how are you balancing all that stuff?
Well, for the first 3 years of high school, I would say the Potomac school is a very hard school. And so we have lots of homework, and it was very hard to balance with softball. Well, senior year, it's like senioritis. I'm fine with it.
checking it.
Yeah, but it's been tough. It's mainly like you go to practice, but you can't really do anything else during the softball season. It would be like practice and then homework, and that's it.
And Faye, you're headed off to college after this year?
Yes.
Where are you headed?
I don't know yet.
Oh, okay. Undecided.
Still making that decision.
All right.
Good.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Haley, how about you? Have you decided yet? Anything going on?
Not yet. Still waiting for some decisions.
Got it. Yep. We're still got a little
exciting
bit of
time of the year.
Yeah. So talk about your. Talk about your team. So, you know, what are the strengths of your team? What do you guys see? What do you guys have to do to be successful this year? What do you see as your strengths?
I think one of our biggest strengths is our team chemistry. A lot of us have known each other for a long time. For example, the three of us have known each other since we've been like 10 years old.
Oh, nice.
That's awesome. And then we've known like some of the other players, either heard of them or played with them too. And we all get along really, really well, I would say. There's never any team drama or anything like that. I feel like we're all like really good friends, to be completely honest.
That's good. Starts with leadership. You got good leadership. You got good, no drama. Right, Kevin?
Yeah.
What's practice look like? What do you guys do? What's one of your best practices? What's it look like? What do you guys do? Like, coach likes to know, is there music blaring? Is it, you know, what's going on? What's a good practice look like?
I love it when we just do like live hitting on the field. You know what I mean?
We do a lot of hitting.
Yeah. It's mainly, I would say mainly hitting.
Is that your philosophy, coach? Is that sort of your...
Hit the ball?
Yeah.
Well, and you got nice. Katie Kuntz in the circle on the other side. You better work on some hitting.
You better learn how to hit. Yeah. Nice. Hit. I love it.
But hit, that's sort of just your, you know, you guys spend a lot of time doing that and enjoy that?
Well, we have a good veteran team. So defensively, we're really strong. Abby's our pitcher, and she's been consistent now for 3 years. Expect her to be consistent for the fourth year. And... therefore, you know, I heard years ago when Tommy Orndorff was the coach at O'Connell, 3 hours of hitting for practice.
Oh, yeah.
And I figure, you know, most teams we're going to out-hit them. Yeah. And, you know, we worked all last spring trying to get ready for Katie. We started out strong. We were ahead for four and a half innings, and then just had one bad hit by them, and that made the difference.
But yeah.
We played really well.
It was a good game. I was there.
Yeah.
So you would just see them in playoffs, or they're not part of your regular schedule, Bishop O'Connell?
No,
so,
they'd only see them at the end.
So who's the team, ladies, that when you're looking at the calendar, you're sort of getting all jazzed up for and pumped and ready to play? Do you have one of those sort of, you know, rival teams?
Do we have the calendar?
I actually, it's not published on your website. I know that because I did look. But just in general, you guys have all been there for 4 years. Do you have that team where you're just like, oh my God, here we go again, or I can't wait to beat them, or anything like that? No,
I would say Potomac in general has a little bit of a rivalry with Flint Hill.
Okay.
It's not always like a great softball game, but it's really fun to beat them.
Yeah. Well, that's, yeah, exactly.
Right. Flint Hill has a new coach this year, right?
Couldn't tell you.
Yep.
Don't know. Yeah.
Yeah. I thought this.
Yeah. I trust you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I always like to ask about personalities. So who's the leader of the team? Do you have somebody that steps in front and leads if something's going down? Is somebody standing in front and everybody else behind her?
They're all looking at Abby, so yeah. I'm going to put my money on her.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah.
I'd like to try to keep the team, like, happy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's my main thing.
That's your role?
But if you were going to rumble with Flint Hill, though, Abby's going to be the one
Abby's
leading the charge.
Lead. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I was going to ask. She didn't disagree. She just
no. She's like, yeah, yeah. I was going to ask about the bat flipping. Like, who on the team would be most likely to flip a bat? But I think I know that answer too. But that's probably Abby. No.
Yeah.
Nobody's.
Yeah,
you I actually don't look like bat flippers as I sit here and contemplate this.
But if you strike somebody out, are you the fist pump? Like, you're going to give the little fist pump?
It depends. Probably.
In the moment.
Especially if it was a changeup.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. That's the go-to pitch?
Yeah. Got a good changeup.
Nice. Yep.
Nice. How about music? What do you guys listen to get sort of dialed in for a game?
I mean, the senior last year had our good big speaker.
But
I just
on
realized
the team.
That.
Her sister.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. So we have a good speaker and a good playlist. I don't really know what type of music, but
it's loud.
Yeah.
There's something
it's,
on.
It's
it, whatever it is, it's loud.
Yeah. Okay.
Turn it up loud and turn up that pitching machine. Go. Go. Yeah.
So as seniors, you know, you guys are enjoying your senior year, your last hurrah. It's the spring of your senior year. But is there a memory in the last 3 years of you guys coming up? Is there something that stands out that you guys, you know, maybe did together that you'll never forget?
Every year we go on a spring break trip. Oh, yeah. So we didn't have one freshman year, but sophomore year we went to Myrtle Beach, and then last year we went to Disney. And I think those two trips have just been, like, really fun because you're staying with your team. It's, like, 4 or 5 days, and you're playing a game, but you're also getting to, like, hang out outside of it. So, like, going to the beach or going to theme parks, like, it was just, like, a really fun experience to both, like, play softball with the team but also, like, get to know people and definitely grow closer.
Is there a trip on tap for this year?
Yes.
Myrtle Beach.
Back to Myrtle. Awesome.
Yeah. I also, like, my favorite time every year is when we play O'Connell, just because it's mm-hmm. so fun. Like, we spend, like, a week just getting hyped for that one game, and then we get all ready for it before. I don't know.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Did you do something a little different pregame to get ready for that?
We have the most hype pregame ever.
Yeah.
It's so fun, yeah. With the speakers in the dugout until the game starts.
Well, that's what it's about, right? Going out there and competing and having a good time doing it.
I mean, the crazy thing is we're 6 miles from O'Connell. We have to commute to Dinwiddie, Virginia.
Exactly.
Well, that's, I'm sure, a good bus trip, though. Yeah. You're looking forward to that trip.
Ladies, you have any superstitions pregame? Like the cleats, the shoes, what you eat, music you listen to?
This is a superstition, but in the dugout we usually have a lot of snacks and I eat a lot of chips before the game, and it doesn't affect my game.
Yeah, it's great nutrition.
Yeah.
A lot of chips. Yeah. Eat lots of chips.
That might be just be called hunger, not superstitious. But
we had a young lady on last week. She said she has a Monster Energy drink and Pop Rocks before every game.
Interesting. Yeah.
I'm like, my stomach, I don't think, could handle that.
No, something else. Yeah.
How about you mentioned sort of the academic rigor at Potomac School. I know that there's a lot of community involvement as well, sort of with what you guys do. How are you guys involved in the community outside of softball, or what are you guys doing, you know, inside your community as well?
Just at Potomac, I think we're all in a bunch of, like, clubs. We have clubs every week, and so we're all involved in that one way or another. And then also, all three of us are on yearbook, so we do that during the winter, which is definitely something that's, like, different but still, like, enjoyable.
What other clubs are you involved in?
I'm on the school newspaper, and then I also help with, like, service learning sometimes.
Awesome. Anybody else?
I'm in the school magazine for art magazine.
Oh, cool.
Oh, very good.
Nice.
I'm in yearbook.
Nice.
Nice.
That's about it.
Do any of the three of you know what you want, you know, as seniors going heading into college? Do you know what you want to study yet?
I want to study business.
Okay.
Don't know what, just that.
I think so too. That's what I've been doing in high school. Like my senior year is basically I'm taking a bunch of classes that are business related, but I'm contemplating doing something I'd maybe be happier with, because I feel like maybe focusing on business I'd be unhappy. But
Faye, we want you to be happy. We really want you to be happy. You're too young to not be happy. Yeah. Abby, how about you?
Probably econ or math.
Okay, cool.
Awesome. So what's your advice for incoming student athletes at Potomac? You guys are on your way out. You had a great experience.
I'd say balance. Like, in general, it's really hard to balance school and sports at Potomac. And I think you have to sometimes accept that going to practice is, like, healthy and, like, worth your time rather than sitting down and doing homework for 7 hours straight. I think practice is just as important, even if you maybe don't get all of your homework done.
Yeah, good perspective. Yeah.
Great perspective. The sun heals you.
Yeah, it does. You know? Yeah. The vitamin D.
It does. Yeah. You need to get out in that sun.
That's right.
Coach, speaking of the young incoming, you got any incoming freshmen or younger folks that that you're looking at?
Yeah, we have two freshmen that are coming that we expect to be on the varsity. One of them is Charlotte Perry, who 13 years ago, her father was the coach at Potomac.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
And then he stepped away. And then the other one is Leighton Mayhammer. Mayhammer. So they're both had the perspective to start and good ball players. And they're both playing travel. So
great.
Oh, very good.
Yeah, the tradition never graduates. Right. And, you know, that's a beautiful thing that you guys can continue on as, you know, this sort of legacy thing that you kind of can bring to the younger players. And then, you know, if it comes full circle with the coach's daughter now becoming a player, it's amazing how that sort of continuity does exist over time.
Sure.
So fantastic for the culture of the program and for you as a coach. And, you know, to be able to share that with a bunch of girls as well. It's pretty cool. Pretty neat.
Indeed.
Coach, anything else?
No, that's it, man. I'm excited to watch you guys. It was a pleasure to meet you.
When do you guys kick it off? When's the beginning of the season for you guys? Because it does a little bit different than, you know, your calendar is a little different than our public school calendar.
Well, we have a couple scrimmages, Riverside and Elizabeth Seton, before spring break. And we take a week off. We have a two-week spring break. First week, no softball. Then the second week, we go to Myrtle Beach. We'll probably play 4 games down there. And then I think we come back. And, like, the last week in March, we play St. John's.
Okay. Great. Well,
you guys are going to love Riverside.
Do you guys have nice facilities at Potomac?
Fabulous facility.
How's your softball field? A little bit to be desired.
It can be worked on.
Have you ever been to Riverside?
No.
Enjoy.
I heard their previous group talking about it.
Yeah.
I didn't.
Enjoy.
You're like spoiling a brand new relationship.
You're going to love it. It's quite the spectacle.
They'll treat you like
I'm sure Alexis will tell us about it.
Alexis will tell you all about it. Yes, exactly. Yeah. Well, guys, thank you so much for coming.
Awesome.
We appreciate it. All the best this season. It's going to be fantastic, and we'll keep a watch out for you. Thanks so much.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Forward to seeing you.
Thank you, guys. Good luck.
Yep.
I can do this.